Deadline looks into the impact of the yen's depreciation on the Korean economy, what negative effect it may have. We visit a food vacuum packaging maker exporting to the overseas market and learn about their secret of success. A smartphone is all you need to pay for what you buy. We introduce the innovative mobile payment service system that can change your lifestyle. We met with Kim Dong-uk, president of Korea Information Society Development Institute, to learn about the prospect of Korea's ICT industry. There are talks that North Korea could be responsible for hacking incidents when they happen, big or small, but do the North have hacker specialists, so-called cyber warriors?
Hello, I'm Andrew Salmon, and welcome to BizLine. We're coming to you today from southern Seoul, and just over there is Taedongno, which is the ground zero for South Korea's ICT, or Information and Communications Technologies sector. And that sector is one of the most advanced on the face of the planet. Why is this so? Well, we can say there are four key pillars holding up South Korea's ICT industry. Number one, a cutting-edge internet and mobile infrastructure. Two, a wide range of world-class companies who are churning out the actual products from semiconductors to smartphones. Three, full government support. And four, as a result of these various factors, a huge population of early adopters who are actually using the technologies. In today's interview segment, we'll be speaking to one of South Korea's key ICT strategists. But before we speak to him, let's take a look at some of this week's economic and business news from around South Korea.
Korea gained the largest market share in the Chinese import market for January and February this year, pushing back the former market leader Japan to a distant third. The Korea Trade Investment Promotion Agency said that Korean goods made up 9.2% in the Chinese import market for the first 2 months of this year, thanks to strong sales in Korean mobile phones and auto parts. Japan's dominance in the Chinese import market has posted a sharp decline over the years, while Korea's relative stability enabled it to snatch first place. Experts say, however, Japanese products could make a comeback in the second half of the year, benefiting from Tokyo's weak yen policy. The Korean average wage increase rate is expected to drop this year compared to last year, mainly due to the country's economic slump. The Korea Labor Institute said that the monthly average wage for each Korean worker will increase only 4.5% this year, down 0.8 percentage points from the year before. Even if the Korean economy grows at a moderate pace of 2.3%, the Institute says it is unlikely the wage growth rate will reach the same level as that of 2012, which was at 5.3%. Samsung Group Chairman Egon Hee returned home from his three-month overseas trip to the US and Japan. Upon his arrival, he told reporters that Samsung must continue to strive for improvement and be wary of times of crises in order to better cope with potential challenges. He also said he was able to meet a lot of people during his trip and take the time to map out future plans for the South Korean conglomerate. As for the newly launched Park Geun-hye administration, he said Samsung will do its best to support the new government. Japanese Governor Haruhiko Kuroda is determined to get the nation's economy out of a prolonged slump. At a news conference, Kuroda pledged to meet the government's inflation target of 2% in 2 years by purchasing more longer-term government bonds and riskier assets. The Bank of Japan announced its plans to double the country's monetary base by the end of 2014, injecting about $1.4 trillion into the economy. Such a move is the biggest in scale since quantitative easing began in 2001. Japanese economists are hopeful the central bank's new stimulus measures will help Japan achieve its target of 2% inflation. Korea's government debt hit $792 billion last year, up some $111 billion from the year before. That's about 71% of the nation's gross domestic product, according to Korea's finance ministry. The reason for the jump is increased liability, stemming from the operation of pension funds. These figures were compiled using the accrual basis accounting rules, which the Korean government adopted last year to give a more accurate portrait of how much debt the country is actually in.
Terms used in international finance may sound to the man in the street like gibberish. Likewise, international finance as a sector may seem like something which has no impact or no relevance on his life at all. Currently in East Asia, the terms we're hearing most in international finance are low yen policy and Abenomics. The low yen is one of the core economic policies of Japan's new Prime Minister, Shinzo Abe. And it's a policy which could have a potentially massive impact on the economy of his country's arch rival in international trade, South Korea. Needless to say, this policy is causing shock, horror, and consternation in boardrooms across Korea Inc. In our special report, we'll take a close look at the possible impact this will have on South Korea's economy.
The busy street of Myeongdong, filled with tourists, shopkeepers welcoming foreigners. Japanese travelers used to be big shoppers here, but they are not spending as much now as before. Yamazaki Runosuke is a foreign exchange student in Seoul. And his life has been affected by the low yen-won exchange rate. All the shops Runosuke goes to, he finds the products to be more expensive than before. There are less Japanese tourists because they are not getting as much as they used to when they exchange the yen into the Korean won.
네, 감사합니다. 엔저 현상 때문에 예전에 비해서는 여기서 생활하는 게 생활비가 좀 더 많이 든 것 같다는 걸 느꼈던 하루였어요.
To make it easier to understand, here is the Big Mac Index, published regularly by The Economist. The index compares the price of a Big Mac sold around the world and translates those prices into US dollars at current exchange rates. The Big Mac still costs 320 yen for purchase in Japan, but after applying the Big Mac Index, what used to be more than 4 US dollars costs around $3.50 as of February. To the Japanese, it's expensive to buy imports or when they are abroad. But for the rest of the world, Japan-made products are getting more price competitive. However, this didn't happen by free market force. It's the work of Abe Shinzo's administration through what is known as Abenomics, aimed at ending decades-long deflation by artificially lowering the Japanese currency against the global counterparts through aggressive quantitative easing. That is, pumping in cash to the market.
이 아베가 엔화 약세를 유도하기 위해서 이 일본의 돈을 푸는 그러니까 양적 완화 정책을 아주 대대적으로 공격적으로 추진한 그 어떤 정책에 힘입어서 지금 엔저 현상이 나타나고 있다고 봅니다.
The Korean won has gotten stronger against the Japanese yen to the level not seen in years. The North Korean risk is seeing some depreciation of the won, but still the yen-won exchange rate is at a worrisome level.
General 한 2004년에서 한 2007년까지 우리가 이제 엔저 현상이 있었고 우리가 원화는 계속 그 강세를 보였던 적이 있습니다. 근데 그 당시랑 지금이랑 상황이 뭐가 다르냐 하면은 세계 경제가 잘 성장하고 있는 그런 프로세스 하에서 뭐 일부 이제 부정적인 영향을 미칠 수는 있었겠습니다만 지금처럼 세계 경제가 어려운 상황에서 일본의 그 통화 정책 때문에 엔화가 약세로 간다고 그런다면 우리나라 수출도 굉장히 그 타격을 받을 수밖에 없는 그런 이제 세계 경제의 호황이라는 그런 버퍼가 없다.
With the Japanese government's intervention, economists are also voicing out concerns for countries that are Japan's main export competitors, namely Germany, South Korea, and China. To zone in on the local front, weaker Japanese yen means Korean products are relatively more expensive in the global market, and that is bound to hurt manufacturers depending on exports. Company in Korea sells 80% of its printers abroad, while half of that is to Japan, and the company is already feeling the heat from the low yen versus the Korean won.
사실 작년하고 올해하고 봤을 때는 완전히 지금 줄어들고 있어요. 작년 이 정도부터 했으면은 벌써 많은 대수가 나갔는데 일본에서 오다가 없습니다. 주문이 없다는 뜻이에요. 그럼 이 중소기업이 어떻게 먹고 사느냐 이거죠. 그리고 상당히 걱정이 많습니다. 수출 금융이라든가 이런 거를 좀 풀어서 중소기업들이 살아갈 수 있도록 해줬으면 좋겠다고 생각합니다.
To address this concerning issue and to assist small and medium-sized manufacturers' call of help, the Korean government recently announced that it will be supporting the exporters by offering low-interest loans. Unfortunately, the bad news continues to the larger Korean manufacturers, namely in steel, auto, and heavy industries. When the yen depreciates by 1%, Korean exports is affected at a similar level.
진짜 피해를 받는 업종들, 이제 그 자동차나 선박은 그거보다도 더 클 수 있겠죠. 미국 시장에서 자동차를 파는 데서 우리나라 이제 한국산 자동차에 대한 할인율은 굉장히 적어질 것이고 일본 차들은 굉장히 할인율이 높게 가져갈 수 있기 때문에 가격 경쟁력이 굉장히 높아지게 되는 것입니다.
But government measures cannot be their only source of relief. Companies would need to look elsewhere to overcome the obstacles.
ENZ가 진행되는 과정에서는 근본 경쟁력을 높이는 것이 더 중요하다고 봅니다. 고부가 가치라든지 고품질 또는 고기술, 고브랜드 이런 어떤 비가격 경쟁력을 높이는 것이 이 ENZ로 인한 가격 경쟁력 또는 수출 경쟁력 약화를 극복하는 데 지름길이라고 보입니다.
Challenges of any kind open doors for other opportunities, even if it takes some time. To keep its competitive edge in the global market, Korean companies will need to stay ahead of its peers, work on to improve product quality, come up with innovative technology, and heighten corporate governance, not just depend on price competitiveness.
So, you've cooked, you've dined, you've finished, you've belched, and you've slapped your belly in contentment. Now comes the time for that onerous chore, clearing it all up. But what do you do with your leftover food? If you're anything like me, you probably stick it in a plastic bag and shove it in the back of your refrigerator. And this is a reasonable short-term solution, but let's face it, most of our leftovers eventually end up in the trash. However, there now may be a better and longer term solution, a home sealed vacuum pack for leftover food. In our Hidden Champion segment, let's meet the company producing this very product.
The food safety issue became an international hot topic following Japan's tsunami disaster, which led to the leaking of radioactive material into local produce. The global eggflation phenomenon is pushing prices up for agricultural products in recent years. A growing number of people are becoming more aware of the process of preserving food, backed by the domestic enthusiasm for well-being. The vacuum packing machine FoodKeeper promises to keep food fresh in its original form, which is the main reason why the product is gaining worldwide recognition. There is a growing interest in improving preservation methods for food. so it can maintain its freshness for a longer period of time. The vacuum packing machine, FoodKeeper, makes airtight preservation of food items possible at individual households.
영양이나 향이나 맛이나 그대로 보존할 수 있다는 장점이 있어서 멀리 있는 친구나 이제 미국으로 시집간 딸에게 그렇게 진공팩을 해서 보내주려고 구매하러 왔어요.
Food vacuum packing machine maker Rollpack has succeeded in creating a small size home appliance that can vacuum pack any food item, adding convenience to the whole idea of food storage.
진공을 각 가정에서 사용을 한다면은요, 굉장히 너무너무 좋습니다. 한 가지는 특히 우리 대한민국 같은 경우는 사계절이 뚜렷하잖아요. 그러면 제 계절에 나오는 음식들, 그러면 땅에서 나오는 것도 있고 바다에서 나오는 것들도 있을 거 아니에요. 그러면은 제 계절, 제철에 나오는 그런 음식들을 다음 철에 가서 먹을 수 있는 방법들이 없어요. 그러다 보니까 다 어떻게 해요? 화학요법으로 뭐 보관을 한다든지 아니면 냉동실에 다 넣는 방법밖에 없잖아요. 근데 냉동실에 넣어도 이미 그 수분 증발이 일반 팩들은 다 이 수분 증발이 될 수밖에 없어요. 그래서 수분 증발이 되거나 아니면 산소 투과가 돼서 그 내용물들이 맛이 떨어지고 결론은 그러다 보면은 버리게 되거든요.
The company makes vacuum packing machines by using specialized film which seals food items, keeping it airtight. Rollpack has created the world's first 7-layer co-extrusion film, which is only 0.074 millimeters thick. It has proved to be outstanding in blocking air and in strength as well as transparency.
여기 보시게 되면은 이런 깡통이 있는데 이게 그 에어로 해서 이걸 갖다가 만약에 찌그러뜨린다면 상당한 압력이 있겠죠. 근데 그 이유는 그 음식을 보관할 때 이 봉투 안이나 어떤 공기 중에 어떤 그런 균이라든가 이런 것들이 증식을 막기 위해서 진공을 하는 건데 그래서 이 경우에 잔류량에 대한 걸 많이 뽑는 게 진공기의 특성입니다. 이렇게 보시면 이게 상당히 적지만 강력한 흡력을 가지고 있습니다. 보이시죠? 상당히 힘이 강력하죠? 이 백 안에 잔류 공기가 다 빠졌다 싶으면 자동으로 그 안에서 센서가 체크를 해서 실링으로 들어가서 이렇게 밀봉을 하게 됩니다. 이렇게 함으로써 이제 공기를 차폐한다는 얘기죠.
Food is placed onto the special film, and with the push of a button, air is sucked out for the vacuum packing process. Ordinary plastic wrap or Ziploc bags simply protect food from dust or insects, but the vacuum packing machine protects the food and its nutrients for a longer period of time.
이 진공 필름은 말 그대로 내용물을 신선하게 맛과 향을 영양물을 그대로 보관할 수 있는 이런 특수 필름입니다. 육안으로 보면은 기존 일반 필름하고 진공 필름하고 똑같지만은요, 진공 필름은 기능을 가지고 있어요. 그래서 이 진공 필름이 굉장히 좋은 거죠.
Housewife Pang Eun-jung used to throw away any leftovers, but after using the FoodKeeper, she says all her problems were solved. Her refrigerator has more space, and she gets to keep her food for an extended period of time.
그 냉동실에 음식을 넣어놓으면 냉동실에 냄새가 전혀 나지 않고요. 이렇게 오랫동안 보관해도 신선함이 그대로 있더라고요. 그리고 그래서 그릇 같은 걸 다 치우고 이제 진공해서 넣게 됐죠.
The specialized packing process can become a solution to reducing food waste while providing healthy food for the family.
통에 넣은 걸 다 진공팩으로 저희가 바꿨어요. 그러니까 냉동실도 훨씬 넓어지고 음식물 쓰레기도 줄어서 그 비용도 되게 절약되는 것 같아요.
The FoodKeeper is not only popular in Korea, but well received in 20 countries around the world. Sales of the FoodKeeper and its air film have all increased, along with growing interest for vacuum packing food.
음식물을 신선하게 오래 보관하다 보니까 그 맛있는 음식을 먹게 되면 내 가족들의 건강도 지켜주고 또 그만큼 버려지는 부분들이 없기 때문에 환경 지킴이도 될 수도 있고 또 경제적으로도 굉장히 각 가정에서 내 저는 경제적으로 도움이 좀 많이 될 겁니다. 그래서 그 일석 뭐 삼조가 되겠지요.
The food vacuum packing industry is gaining more grounds amid concerns of food safety. Food vacuum packing is becoming a global industry powered by a worldwide trend which focuses on people's health and well-being. The yearning for safer and better food will forever be an important topic for the entire humanity. The trend that cares for the well-being of families and individuals is becoming an industry and also a culture.
I don't think I need to introduce this gadget to you because you probably already have one. It is, of course, a smartphone. It's the latest all-in-one technology, packaging information, communication, and entertainment, and it all fits in your inside pocket. The latest addition to the package, though, is a technology, an application which turns your smartphone into a credit card. We're going to have a look at the technology inside this app, which allows you to go shopping by telephone. And I hope my wife isn't watching this.
As smartphones become more available, people are turning to mobile payment methods, which is paving the way for a future trend. Soon, people are expected to walk around without cash, but instead rely on the next generation smartphones, which will take up the role of wallets. It's a common sight to see people on their morning commute to work use the smartphone to pay for their subway fees. Internet shopping has also gone mobile thanks to the smartphone, which takes care of everything from browsing, shopping, and purchase of online products. Office worker Yumi Son says she often leaves her wallet at her desk because her smartphone can basically pay for whatever she wants to buy. She always carries her smartphone around, which also pays for her coffee. The mobile payment service brings huge advantages since it applies possible discounts when the payment is being made, even without providing coupons or membership cards.
예전에는 이제 자주 다니는 곳에 멤버십 카드들을 일일이 들고 다녔거든요. 포인트 적립을 하기 위해서. 근데 이제 그럴 필요가 없으니까 지갑도 가벼워지고 또 깜빡 잊고 놓고 오는 일도 없으니까 사용이 편리한 것 같아요.
The size of the worldwide mobile payment market for last year jumped 62% from the previous year, 2011, to reach $171.5 billion. That figure is expected to become $617 billion by year 2016, creating a potentially enormous market. The earliest form of mobile services, such as small sum payment and mobile banking, are being widely used, with some 7 out of 10 people using those services. By replacing the USIM chip inside a mobile phone with a credit card chip, one can use the mobile phone as a credit card. Application stores are providing mobile payment application downloads with the increase in smartphone users, leading the way for market expansion. Korea's leading credit card companies plan to join forces to launch a mobile payment application.
유심형 모바일 카드 같은 경우는 이제 카드를 추가로 발급받아야 되기 때문에 고객들이 가입 절차가 좀 번거로웠고요. 그리고 NFC 폰에만 한정되기 때문에 고객들이 제한이 돼 있었습니다. 근데 앱형 모바일 카드 같은 경우는 스마트폰이면 어떤 기종이든 앱을 설치해서 바로 가입하고 사용하기 가능하기 때문에 저희가 개발하게 되었습니다.
Mocha Pay is the latest in mobile payment application, receiving a lot of market attention.
ATM기의 기능을 이용하지 않고서도 스마트폰의 기능을 가지고 ATM기의 기능을 다 수행할 수 있습니다.
The recent application works like a wallet, with diverse services readily available. The application automatically searches for coupons and membership points, which lowers the price for users when they make the payment. The latest mobile payment application allows the bank to pay the store when the customer approves the process by punching in the password, which is the opposite of how other mobile payment services do their transaction, which has users provide personal financial information to the store.
내가 가서 쓰려고 하는 순간에 내가 갖고 오지도 않은 쿠폰을 클라우드 상에 있는 어떤 멤버십 서버와 연결이 돼서 쿠폰 서버와 연결이 돼서 결제하려고 하는 순간에 물건을 사고 결제하는 순간에 갖고 있는 쿠폰, 내가 쓸 수 있는 쿠폰을 한꺼번에 정리해 주고 또 그걸 할인 혜택을 받을 수 있고 한꺼번에 결제와 함께 정리해 준다 그러면은 결제 처리 속도는 약 90%까지도 세이브가 되고 즉 뭐 2분 걸릴 거 약 10몇 초만 걸리면 되는
The latest mobile payment application reduces the risk of hacking and is safe even in the case of smartphone loss. The service does not provide personal financial information to the store, nor is it saved in the smartphone. Instead, such information gets downloaded every time a transaction is made through the cloud server.
안전을 담보라는 편리, 또 편리함을 담보라는 안전. 근데 그런 어떤 기능적인 그런 안전의 가치를 넘어서 그야말로 소비자한테 많은 혜택을 주는 그 혜택이라는 것이 어떤 경제적 가치도 있고 당연히 기본적으로 그다음에 어떤 영혼의 가치를 담는 그런 걸로 계속 발전해 나가는
The future of payment methods is expected to change from the point of sales terminal at stores which deals with the mass to a more personalized payment service using the smartphone. Frequent use of smartphone payment will allow stores to compile personalized transaction information as data. The transaction data can become big data on the cloud server, utilized to provide personalized services and products.
현재 모바일 카드나 모바일 결제 서비스는 다양한 서비스들이 존재하고 있고 아직 어느 것이 주도적이라고 할 수 없는 상황입니다. 앞으로는 모바일로 이용한 쇼핑이나 결제가 늘어나고 전자지갑에서 제공하는 모바일 쿠폰이나 멤버십, 가맹점 정보들이 점점 통합되면서 고객들이 훨씬 더 편리하고 안전하게 모바일로 결제할 수 있는 환경이 조성될 것으로 예상됩니다.
Soon, smartphones are expected to provide combined payment services rather than simple mobile services. We can look forward to an innovative worldwide mobile payment market poised for growth in the coming future.
Hello and welcome to our interview segment. Now, as we said earlier in the show, ICT, information and communications technology, is a critical sector of the Korean economy. How does policy making affect this? Well, our guest today is someone who's wide experience both in ICT and in policy making. He's currently the head of the KISTI, which is the Korea Information Society Development Institute. Kim Dong-wook, thank you for joining us today on BizLine.
Thank you.
Dr. Kim, let's begin. Park Geun-hye's administration, one of the key metrics which will determine its success or its failure is of course going to be job creation.
Yes.
Youth unemployment is a critical problem in Korea today. There's a lot of talk in the new administration about the so-called creative economy. What is the interface between the so-called creative economy and the ICT sector?
For at least 5 or 6 years, the Korean economy is under trap of $20,000. And the Korean economy is led by the large companies and the manufacturing. But problem is the manufacturing and the large company does not create the new jobs. So the Korean government try to build a new strategy of economic systems. It's we called creative economy. A creative economy try to build up some efficiency system, utilize the creative idea and imagination, personal imagination, and scientific technology into the new systems.
What would you say, I mean, what is going to be the core interaction, the core interface between, on the one hand, a creative knowledge-based economy and the actual technology of ICT? How do those two link together?
Lots of new idea and creative technology is in form of digital contents. So digital contents create and managed and spread through the software and digital network like internet. ICT is highly related to the new idea and new technologies. ICT is kind of a birthplace of innovation.
Gotcha.
So the we cannot talk about a creative economy without ICT.
Let's look at a little bit of historical background to this. You know, Korea today is noted appropriately as a world leader, particularly in broadband, internet backbone, and also, of course, in CDMA and mobile telecommunications. What's the background to this? How did Korea get this, make this kind of great leap as a technological powerhouse?
In the mid-1990s, very luckily, Korean government tried to build up the fiber optic network across the country. So 2 or 3 years later, you know that the World Wide Web explosion that took place. So the Korean government sponsored broadband network, very luckily, meet the explosive demand for the broadband traffic. Later, not only the wired network, but also wireless network also successfully built it through the fierce competition among network common carriers, because the three, KT, SKT, and LG Uplus,
the three main carriers now,
their competition so severe, so they try to the 2G and the 3G, and now it is LTE 4G network. They tried to build that network earlier than their competitors. Government designed the competition among common carriers becomes the competition, the speed build up the new networks.
Got you. So if I understand you correctly, you're suggesting it was a far-sighted government decision making, competition policy.
Yes.
And in addition
to the government's and the business efforts, I should say that the Korean people are ready to spend large portion of their income to spend the brand new service and the brand new devices.
Gotcha. I mean, Koreans are noted for being early adopters.
Yes.
What is why are Koreans so keen to be first with new technology? Is this the sort of innate competitiveness of the modern South Korean people? What's the social thing behind this?
At birth, Korean people is under high competition pressure.
Right.
In order to survive in our society, every Korean people try to be equipped with one strength over other people. That caused somewhat is the speed as a very important value for their survival or their success. So as you know, the ICT has a very short cycle technologically
and moving forward all the time
in business model. Almost every year or every month, we witnessed the brand new service, brand new devices.
Right. Dr. Kim, is there a sense that, you know, Korea's economy has been spectacularly successful in manufacturing, and still metal bashing drives the Korean economy, but there perhaps is now a need to move beyond simple manufacturing, move more heavily into services, more into value-added job creation.
Yes.
Is ICT the solution? Is ICT the holy grail in that situation?
I think so. In the developed country, including Korea, the manufacturing sector does not create enough new jobs. The same as in Korea. For ICT industry, the network and the device, such as broadcasting and communication network and pass and display and the semiconductors does not create the enough jobs, but software and contents and internet and the mobile sector created a large number of new jobs. So now the Korean government focus on the software contents and mobile, including internet. Lots of Korean people hunger for the new jobs and the sure. good jobs. Mm-hmm. So we need more jobs in somewhere other than the ICT. So strategically, we try to converge the ICT and other areas, such as agriculture and fishery, and manufacturing services by utilizing ICT to enhance their productivities, improve the qualities, and expand the new global markets. So I think the some new jobs created in ICT sector for the software contents and the mobile and the internet, more jobs created in convergence of ICT and other industries.
You mentioned just now fisheries and agriculture. Now this is a sector which is under significant pressure in Korea with cheap imports coming in from around the world. Can you give any examples of how ICT is helping fisheries or agriculture? Any specific examples?
You go to the countryside in Korea, lots of the white vinyl house.
Oh, the sort of vinyl greenhouses.
Greenhouse. Yeah. So there, up to now, the lots of labor are needed, but utilizing the ICT is some automated system for the watering, spreading the seeds.
Yeah.
ICT calculated the optimal timing, and optimal quantity of water and optimal the distance between the spread seeds.
Gotcha.
So the ICT improved the productivity in the agriculture in the vinyl greenhouses.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. In the late 1990s, Korea had arguably the finest broadband network and mobile telecoms infrastructure on Earth. I've noticed that in the last few years, traveling back to Europe, traveling elsewhere in Asia, that other countries now seem to enjoy pretty much the same level of services. Is Korea's actual internet and mobile backbones still ahead of the rest of the world? Or has the rest of the world caught up? If so, can Korea maintain its customary lead in this area?
I think the Korean ICT network still the outstanding compared to any other countries' networks. Not only the broadband, I mean the wired network, but also wireless network. The people enjoy the high-speed internet service anytime, any place, in a low cost. Especially the LTE, nationwide LTE network is spread a very short 1 or 2 years.
What is LTE?
LTE is the long-term evolution. It's kind of a technological terminology.
It is.
It's 10 times faster than the three-generation networks.
Gotcha.
10 to 30 megabps. I still mentioned the technological terms.
We've got to keep it as simple as possible for some of the dummies who are not quite as high-tech as yourself, Dr. Kim.
The severe competition among three common carriers in Korea, KT, SKT, and LG U+, caused speed build-up LTE networks. The government designed three common carrier compete each other in order to
raise
the set up the 3G and the 4G network in speed mode.
Dr. Kim, as both an expert policymaker and an expert in the technology side of ICT, speaking again, very, very broad brush, what do you see as the future trends in the Korean ICT sector?
Recently, the vice president of a global ICT companies visit our institution, and KISTI, and they commonly agree with my idea that the Korean young generation has very strong, competitive, I mean the world best in terms of global mindset and hunger for the new creativity and foreign language skills, and most importantly, ICT utilization. I proposed them to invest their money and their technology on Korean young generation. They fully agree with me. The future innovation will take place in the Northeastern Asian region, including Korea and China. They regard the Korean young generation as good fortune for their investment. So I expect the Korean ICT make good success story in next decades. I hope Korean ICT industry will succeed not only domestically, but also internationally, especially the Eastern Asian region, in terms of creativity and efficiency and global cooperation.
So I guess two key trends then, more regional integration,
yes,
in Northeast Asia, and hopefully South Korea will continue to be used as a test lab or a test market by global IT giants due to, as you say, its population of increasingly globalized and very IT savvy young people. Dr. Kim, thank you very much for joining us on BizLine.
It was thank
a
you.
Pleasure. Let's move on to our regular North Korea segment. Today, knowledge is power, and that power is disseminated through information networks. This makes cyber attack a real risk, causing damage, inconveniences not only to individuals and to companies, but also potentially disabling infrastructure, governance structures, even military systems. In this dangerous new world, there are rumors, reports, and allegations that North Korea is deploying a unit of hacker attackers. In some shadowy Pyongyang directorate, does such a unit truly exist? And if so, what are its capabilities?
At around 2 p.m. on March 20th, 32,000 computers and servers at South Korea's three broadcasters, three banks, and two insurance firms were shut down for unknown reasons, acutely disrupting communications and banking transactions. Hackers planted a malware into the systems. As soon as the attacks took place, suspicion centered on Pyongyang.
이번 3월 20일 사이버 테러에서 농협 등 수차례에 걸쳐 대남 해킹을 주도한 북한 정찰총국의 해킹 수법과 유사한 증거들을 발견하였습니다.
북한이 사이버전을 굉장히 중요한 어떤 공격 수단으로 활용한다는 것. 예전에도 언론사를 해킹한 선례가 있었던 거하고요. 그러니까 우리가 키 리졸브 훈련하면서 계속 보복을 하겠다라고 했거든요.
Former U.S. National Coordinator for Security Richard A. Clark ranked the North's cyber power third in the world, following Russia and the United States. The South Korean government estimates Pyongyang has 1,000 very highly skilled hackers and 3,000 supporting personnel, including hackers and computer engineers. It may seem unlikely that North Korea, with one of the most restrictive internet policies in the world, would have such capacity. But for decades, the impoverished North has poured money into science and technology, including training a team of computer-savvy cyber warriors, especially in the past decade or so.
80년대에 들어와서는 이제 본격적으로 군의 뭐 과학기술 분야든 이제 정치 분야든 모두 이제 그 김정일이 청소를 했어요. 국방과학기술 발전을 해야 된다. 거기에서도 가장 첫째가 정보전, 전자전이다. 아, 이거를 상당한 정도로 그때부터 강조를 했고요. 그래서
North Korea starts them young. Outstanding elementary students are recruited to the nation's top middle schools, where they are known to spend 500 hours every year mastering technology from software programs to professional hacking tools. And a selected few are sent to study abroad to sophisticate their hacking skills. Then they are placed in the military to carry out various hacking maneuvers, including collecting intelligence, developing and spreading malicious computer codes to destroy their usual targets, South Korean and American networks and servers.
북한 내에서 이 친구들이 해킹을 시도하는 게 아니고 중국이나 유럽에 가서 이제 남한 쪽으로 해킹을 시도하거든요. 그러니까 이제 아무래도 삶이 좀 나을 수밖에 없단 말이죠. 그렇다 보니까 대우가 좋으니까 좀 열심히 하기도 하고요.
결합형으로 다닙니다. 지금 사이버 팀이요. 그러니까 자기가 이제 우리가 이렇게 지금 다섯 명의 한계 조닥을 하면은 이 한계자가 독립적으로 해외에 나가서 거처를 안 합니다.
South Korea has accused North Korea of masterminding a series of cyber attacks on the websites of government agencies and financial institutions over the past few years. Pyongyang denied all the allegations.
공식적으로 확인된 건 6건입니다. 여기서 공식적으로 확인됐다라는 것은 언론 보도에 나간 게 6건이고요. 실제로 우리나라 정부에서는 북한발 해킹이라고 의심되는 것들을 계속해서 모니터링을 합니다. 그런데 매년 그게 증가하고 있는 추세고요. 과거에는 정부기관을 많이 그 주 목표로 했었는데 요새는 민간 분야로 많이 넘어오고 있는 실정입니다.
The South Korean government traced these assaults to Chinese IP addresses.
그 개발 그러니까 소스에 보면은 이 파일이 뭐 저장되거나 하는 이런 어떤 뭐 경로 같은 게 이렇게 소스 코드에 남을 때가 있거든요. 그런데 보면은 그 뭐 이렇게 약간 좀 한글로 된 이런 뭐 이름 경로라든가 뭐 한글로 된 어떤 파일명이라든가. 근데 이런 한글로 된 부분이 이제 우리나라에서 일반적으로 보지 못했던 그런 음절 있잖아요. 예, 그런 게 있었을 때는 의심을 할 수 있는 거죠.
It is odd that South Korea, one of the world's telecommunications and IT powers, appears to be somewhat vulnerable to cyber attacks.
우리나라는 일단 인프라가 좋잖아요. 좋기 때문에 전 세계에서 어느 나라 사람이든지 편안하게 접근이 가능하잖아요. 그러면 다 타겟이 될 수 있는 거고 북한 같은 경우에는 일단 접속 인터넷이 우리가 접근을 할 수가 없잖아요. 접근을 할 수 없는데 그래도 보면은 그쪽에서 운영하는 이제 사이트들이 이게 몇 개가 보여요. 이제 카지노 같은 우리 도박 사이트 같은 경우도 운영을 하는 것도 있고 그다음에 그 특산물 이제 쇼핑몰 프로그램 같은 거 이제 배포하는 거 있잖아요. 뭐 캡처 프로그램 같은 거 무료 프로그램들 뭐 그런 것도 있고.
Just last week, one of the North's propaganda websites, 우리 민족끼리, traced to a Chinese IP, was forced down by the hacktivist group known as Anonymous.
North Korean government to stop making nukes and nuke threats. Kim Jong-un to resign. It's time to install a free direct democracy in North Korea.
이걸 예를 들어 보복하겠다라고 해서 대응 공격을 준비하면 이게 사실은 굉장히 좀 큰 문제로 커질 수가 있거든요. 그래서 사실은 지금 굉장히 그 미묘한 시기에 이런 어떤 해킹 사고가 터져서 정부 당국은 그 2차 보복 해킹이 또 오지 않을까 해서 굉장히 지금 촉각을 곤두세우고 있습니다.
Experts predict the next cyber attacks will likely be on South Korea's financial and national infrastructures such as banks, power plants and traffic networks, which would cause more wide-scale financial and social chaos. It is asymmetric warfare from the get-go. The communists have nothing to lose. And it is cheaper and faster for them to develop malicious computer codes than building nuclear devices or other weapons of mass destruction. So what is it going to be next?
And that wraps up this week's show. Thanks very much for joining us. We hope you enjoyed everything you saw. We especially hope you enjoyed our new segment on ICT. This will now become a regular part of the show. We'll be bringing you all the latest gadgets and technologies to help you become an early adopter like all the cool kids here in Gangnam. And that brings us to the end of BizLine for another week. Thanks for joining us. I'm Andrew Salmon. See you next week. Goodbye.